What's going on, party people? Sarcast here. Welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time here, these are members only videos. Yes, where if you're a member of this channel, you get to control videos like this. Q&A's, you get to ask me questions, things you know, and other things. But, you know, if you just stumbled upon this video, that's what this is. So shout out to UT Smith for making this video possible. Let's get into it. We got 15 questions. Let's go. Obviously, both. But okay. The question is, would you rather someone that loves you or someone that's loyal to you? Both. Yeah, I can't pick one. Someone that's loyal to you, okay, but doesn't love you, okay. Not even a dog is like this. I'm sorry. Because you, woman, have a loyal dog that doesn't love you. It don't make no sense. Have a dog that loves you, that loyal. You know, so then I'm just bringing up the person that's loyal but don't love you. That ain't going to work. The person that loves you, that ain't going to work. It's got to be both. Sorry. Can't pick. Yeah. Number two. Can a relationship still work if either party doesn't get along with their spouse's family? That's a good question. And, I have two answers for that. Yes and no. I'm speaking for myself. And how my family is, the person that I'm with, if they're looking to like, oh, like it's, well, it's, they, everyone has a process, and my parents have gone through their process or going through whatever. I don't concern myself with that. I don't have time. So I'm in a space. Okay, so I'm in a space where I'm trying to build a life with someone, make life. If sometimes that life interacts with the family, cool. But it ain't gonna be kumbaya. It is what it is. Now, some people that they want to have that, and so it wouldn't work with a person, and that's fine as well. So you just gotta find what's going to work for you. But again, to speak for myself, yeah. I mean, I've had experiences when I've seen, you know, that, you know, when I was in the relationship that they came around my family and it was fine. So I see the growth, but I'm no more in the space where it's like, yes, this has to be this. It is what it is. If it happens, it happens. Things just got to flow. I'm trying to build my shit. You know, if the concern is about, oh, yeah. For me, I know it'd be a problem. It's like, yo, don't force shit. Let it flow. Listen. Yeah. Number three. Are you patient during an argument with a significant other, or do you match their energy? It depends. Usually, I can do the patience thing. It depends on what it is, because, yeah, and again, my face can't hide it. So, when I think you're saying something stupid, you're going to see it on my face. I'm looking like you're stupid. So, sometimes it'll be a lot of my facial expressions, less me talking. But, like, if it takes me a while to match energy, it has to take a lot to get me to match. Yeah, it has to take me a lot to get there. So, it's usually a lot of face and body. Yeah. So it all depends. Hope that answered your question. Number four. If you propose to someone and they turned you down, could you continue on with the relationship? First of all, I mean, yeah, you've seen these Bible videos and shit that be going on. I proposed to one person in my life, and I knew she wasn't going to say no. So my whole thing is this. When you're going to propose to somebody, if anything in your mind, if there's any no, if there's like a, you know, if there's any no in there, don't do it. And that's a discussion you should be having with the person that you're possibly going to marry, so y'all know where y'all both are. So, yeah, I can't answer that because I would not propose to someone that I have a feeling they may say no. So, Where am I? Number five. What? You're in love with a woman who has children, but has petty. What? I'm gonna have to look. What's that? PM. Okay, what? You're in love with a woman who has children, but she has petty BM or BD because they're jealous. What? What is BM or BD? What's that? Did it do a spell check for you? A spell check correction? What? I don't know what that is. What? Am I lost in lingo? What? But she has petty BM or BD because they're jealous. What? I don't know what that is. I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna have to skip this one. You gotta come back at another one. I don't know. I don't know. Just making sure the battery and the camera ain't shut off. Number six. Do you believe love hurts, or someone who doesn't know how to love you hurts you? The latter. Someone who doesn't know how to love you hurts you. Because, you know, we want to throw around this word love, you know, let's go in love languages, blah, 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 blah. And not even, you know, just take out the word love language. You can't love everybody the same way. Everyone don't receive love the same way. So, it's not the love, it's how to love that individual. So, I don't believe, no, love, though, it's someone who doesn't know how to love you. Yeah, hurt you. Hopefully that made sense with that. Okay, we still recording. Cool, make sure. Number seven, do you have gender roles because you are viewed as the more masculine female in the relationship? No, I'm saying that's a discussion I have with whomever I'm dealing with. That's a question I ask because, yeah, I look this way, but I'm a girl. I'm a girl. I'm a woman. I don't believe. No. Now, individuals have different strengths and weaknesses. So those will appear in relationships, but I don't tie them to masculinity. And we both can pull out a garbage bin because that seems to be an example. Put out, who take out the garbage? Garbage is garbage. You take it out, you put it there, you could take it out too. I'm just saying, but if it's heavier and it's something that I could lift, shit like that, but it's fucking garbage from the bathroom, you could take that shit out too. I'm just saying, I don't believe in that shit. Dude. In all aspects, I don't believe in that shit. We're two women. We have differences. Differences don't latch on to masculine or feminine. This is my answer because it was asked to me. How you doing? Yeah, I'm high. Whatever. Still recording? Yeah. Number eight. Do you believe it's okay to follow exes on social media if you're in a new relationship? I don't have a problem with it. Because, again, using myself as an example, there's exes that we follow each other on social media. We grown. Ain't nothing going on. So if ain't nothing going on while I'm single, if I'm with somebody, what the fuck's something gonna happen? Nah. But I would say, if the person you're dealing with, they know they have an issue, that's something to talk about. Me, can't speak with me. If that was something, we're going to talk about it, and I'm not, again, if I'm not doing something, I'm not going to, I'm not going to change. It's kind of similar to a situation. If I ain't doing nothing, what's going on? What's the trigger in what I'm doing? What's going on? We could talk about that, but yeah, I don't see no problem with it because, again, you have to know your intention and why you're doing something. You feel me? Like, if you following your ex and you just trying to look at what they doing, oh, what they doing, who they with today, that's the problem. I ain't got time for that bullshit. I ain't got time. Yeah. What's your intentions? Yeah, while I'm looking at the next question, I'm thinking. See, when you high, it should be, yeah, I like that. But I was thinking about that question and referring to last situation. I believe that Even depending on how a relationship ended, this is personally me. I don't wish any of them bad. you just ain't, you could take that song. I don't wish them bad. I want you happiness. If it ain't with, it ain't with me, just want you to be happy. But I've been, you know, it's been said to me, like, you know, moved on. An ex has said to me, oh, when I got with someone else, oh, they had hoped that didn't work. See, that's what I'm saying. That's the crazy shit. That's that, nah. What's your intention? Like, okay, why are you following him? It's like people wishing you well. Everybody well wishes ain't well wishes. Watch that shit. Don't pray for me. Pray for yourself. I'm good. So, again, it falls back to your intentions. And what's... It's your intention. You grown. Next. But. That was number eight. Number nine. Do you believe in fate or do things happen because of our decisions? I believe it's a little bit of both. A little bit of both. Yeah. Excuse me. A little bit of both. Definitely. Number 10. Are there any bad habits that you have already stopped? Yeah, I've spoken about it. You know, bad habits, suck my finger. Yeah, that's what we're doing. A little bad. Biting my nails. Yeah. That wasn't my nails. That's a hang thing. Hang nail. I cut a piece of my... Yeah. But I don't bite my nails. But yeah, that was a... Yeah. Funny thing. Just did it on camera. Number 11, is there anything from your past that you're ashamed of? Nope. Everything that has happened has led me to this place. Whether it be good or bad, a lesson had to be learned either. I'm good. Nah. Number 12, do you follow your heart or intuition? Heavy on the intuition. I'm already there's a, you wear your heart on your sleeve, you have your big heart. That's already there. So I don't, that's not something I have to try. It already is. So I'm heavy on the intuition. Now the thing for me is to really listen to it more and stop second guessing it, because it hasn't stirred me wrong. I just need to listen to it more. 13, what are two funny memories you have about your childhood that involve your brother? Off the top of my head, you know, growing up young. When we were younger, you know, in the house that we grew up in, had fly to stick out of it, probably like between 13 and 15 stairs, and there's a little turn, like two more stairs going down. This is in the house, carpeted. We had this white basin. We'd sit in it and go down the stairs and shit. That was fun. And what else? Another one in the backyard. It was a two-family house, and then it was a base. So it was like, oh God, it was so it was two families. So in the backyard, well, going down, if you go down to the basement, it's metal stairs. You live with anyone New Yorker, you've seen New York movies, you've seen the the fire escapes, the metal, it was the gate, the fence was made like that, the stairs and blah, blah, blah. So it was sturdy enough to, we'd hang a string and we put, we tried different things. I think we didn't use a tire. I think, yeah, we used a tire and a piece of wood and we made a swing hang from the stairs above concrete stairs. But see, that's when kids, we played outside and we're creative. Yeah, shit like that. We, you know, yeah. Used to throw water balloons out the window and the neighborhood she used to come to tell our daddy. Whatever, Mrs. Robinson. That's really her name. Where am I? Ba-ba-ba. 14. What's the worst and best thing about being a female in your opinion? Well, I love everything about being a female, so I can't pinpoint one. I love everything. But the worst, but I don't have to do it anymore, is menstruation. Thank the Lord. I think that's the worst. I think you should be able to turn that shit on and off. The devil. Shit. Last but not least... You tried it. Yeah, I'm gonna read the question, but yeah, you ain't getting no answer to this, but you get an E for effort. If you were forced to post one of your secrets on social media, what would it be? Stop it. I'm not being forced. It ain't happening. And if I was being forced, yeah, it ain't happening. Anyway, y'all, members, I appreciate y'all. Thank you, T. Smith. You always come with the heat with the questions. I appreciate you very, very much. Hope y'all enjoyed this. Anything, you know, if you enjoyed any part of this, make sure you hit that thumbs up. If you ain't like it, hit that thumbs down twice. It's all good. Catch you in the vlog. Anyway, guys, I'm out.